Hi, welcome to Sexy Timeless Talk. This show is going to be dedicated to one of the 10 timeless sexy assets that lie within you. And I talk about that in my book, Sexy Timeless. And that asset is knowledge. Today, we are going to be learning a little bit more how to invest in the stock market. I am Luisa Diaz, author and founder of Luisa Diaz Foundation, which is a celebration of kindness. Let me introduce to you my fabulous friends and co-host.
Hi, I'm Samantha Basuto-Drucker, your lifestyle genie and host of Love and Design Project, coming to you from Hollywood Beach, Florida. And a little shout out, thank you to Susan Stern of Weissman Canada for lending me your fabulous apartment while we are in construction upstairs. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Perry. Oops, sorry, Delaney.
That's okay. Hey, everyone. I'm Delaney Dixon, editor-in-chief of DivaGalsDaily.com, creator of the comedy series All About Eve, and I'm coming to you live from Grovetown, Georgia.
Hi, I'm Karen Diane Johnson. I'm coming to you live from Boston, Massachusetts, and I am a managing director at a financial technologies firm in Boston.
Hi, Karen. How are you? Thank you so much for being our special guest today. We are so excited to have you because we are so excited to hear and learn more about the stock market. Yes, girls?
Yay!
But before we go and learn, how was the 4th of July, ladies? What do you do, Samantha?
Well, I watched some illegal fireworks from the beach that was supposed to be closed in from my window. That was lovely. And I watched the national ones on CNN, which were spectacular. But this year, I couldn't help but think to myself, the millions of dollars that were spent on pyrotechnics could have been used to give every student in this country an iPad for distance learning. Just a thought.
I agree,
yeah.
What about you, Delena? What do you do?
Well, I was eating way too much. I ate a lot of pecan pie as I celebrated here in Grovetown with my family. And we played the game Pochino. Do you guys know about this game? It's like,
no,
it's bingo, but it's played with cards and you actually put down, just like bingo, but you yell Pochino instead. And my family, it's a tradition and they get a little bit rowdy during the game. So it was a fun 4th of July.
Oh, wonderful. Family and friends, that's the best. What about you, Karen?
Well, you know, I live where it all started in Boston. And so we watched a lot of illegal fireworks as well. We had fireworks display going on for about 3 hours. And we also watched the surprise Macy's fireworks that apparently have been going on all week in New York. I'm a native New Yorker and I had no idea. And so we spent a quiet Independence Day. But it was lovely.
Oh, well, I was very disappointed that this year I was not able to see some fireworks. I know that Macy has like 3 days fireworks, but I was not be able to really follow up with it. Like, where was it? Because it was kept secret. So, but one of the things I like to do for the 4th of July is, ladies, I go real bad on my eating, which is I eat a hot dog.
That's all right.
Yes.
It's not going to kill you.
Hot dog, girls. Guilty as charged.
And oh, girl.
All right. That's okay. Here's the hot dog.
But only for the 4th of July. But this time, my husband, he makes the hamburger with this called Beyond Meat.
Oh, yeah.
Burger. Oh, my God. It is all vegetable and it's not delicious. And I highly recommend it. And we just cook in the house, and we went to Central Park, and we have a beautiful picnic, very relaxing in the blanket, very romantic, and just enjoying nature and enjoying ourselves. So it was a beautiful time. We're trying to make the best of everything, right? We're supposed to go to Hampton. We're supposed to be in Central Park. Nothing of that happening, and you know what's going on in the country. But ladies, with that said, I am so excited to have Karen today. Because I don't know about you ladies, but I have no idea. I don't understand very well about the stock market. And it can be, you know, it can be a little bit intimidating process. So because the stocks are not like savings account. So Karen, let's just start simple, very simple. What is the stock market? and what we should know about it.
Okay. So the stock market is actually a series of exchanges where people can buy and sell stocks. And every time you buy and you sell a stock, that transaction gets recorded. And so some of the stock markets that you might be familiar with would be the New York Stock Exchange or the American Stock Exchange or the NASDAQ. And some of the stocks that trade on those exchanges are companies that we know very well, Facebook, IBM, GE, GM. So those are the types of stocks that trade on those exchanges. And then there are also international exchanges. There are exchanges in London, there are exchanges in Germany. So the world has an amalgamation of exchanges.
So it's like a piece of company that you own, right?
Yes, a stock. If you're describing a stock and you think about a stock is a small portion of equity. We call it equity in a company. And so when a company goes public, you might have heard the word IPO, initial public offering. It means that a company has decided to make shares available to the public so that they can invest in that company. And if a company does well, they will pay you dividends and the stock will grow. And if it doesn't do so well, then the stock might decline.
And what do you think, what is your advice for people that never invested before and how can they get started? I'm sorry, Samantha, after this, if you can have a question.
Sure.
Yeah. Go ahead, Karen.
So
for people that never have invested before?
I think that it sounds really daunting and it sounds scary to invest in the stock market, but like anything else, you should start by doing research. And what I tell anyone that's interested in the stock market is that it's very simple. Start watching the financial news. Go to the section of wherever you get your news online and look at the financial news so that you can start to get familiar with the terms of finance. Yes. And then think about saving money. Once you put away your emergency fund, you can start saving money, even if it's as little as $10 a week, to start putting that towards building up enough capital to open an investment account.
Mm-hmm. And I have a difficult understanding the difference about the stocks and funds.
Okay, so there are many, many different ways of investing. As Louisa pointed out in the beginning of the show, we all know what savings accounts are, we all know what checking accounts are, and they pay very, very low interest rates, if anything. And so the stock market, there are different ways you can invest in the stock market. You can buy stocks directly, or you can buy mutual funds. And if you buy a mutual fund is a pool of money that is invested in a wide variety of stocks. Personally, I prefer mutual funds because they give you what's called diversification. Mm-hmm. So you might have a mutual fund that owns Nike. You might have a mutual fund that owns Apple. You might have a mutual fund that owns utilities. You have all of these different types of stocks. And so you don't have as much exposure to one stock if there is bad news and that stock goes down. So one of the things that are good about mutual funds is that it allows you to diversify your risk. And we can talk about that. I'll turn it back to Louisa.
Okay, wonderful. The mutual fund has lower risk than the stock. The stock is, you have such a higher risk. So, Samantha, I know that you are dying to have a question, darling.
Dying, burning question. What is the difference between a stock and a commodity, like pork bellies, for example?
Great question. So when you think about commodities, you think about things like oil, you think about gold, you think about silver. We call those hard assets. And when you think about a stock, you think again about a partial ownership in a company. So if you're going to invest in commodities, which personally I haven't done, I can't say that I don't recommend it or I do recommend it. It it is an asset class that has a lot more risk than I'm comfortable with. But you can buy gold, you can buy silver, you can buy oil, you can buy pork bellies. You can use investment instruments that are called options and futures, and that's a little bit more advanced, but it allows you to have exposure to those instruments.
Wow.
Does that make sense?
I learned something new.
And Lena, I know that you have a question as well.
I do. Well, you mentioned an emergency fund. So how much should we have an emergency fund before we even start investing?
I would say personally that, and especially after what we are all living through here, that you should try to have at least 3 to 6 months worth of living expenses that are put aside in case you find yourself in an unexpected financial situation. Many people have been furloughed. Many people have been laid off. Now, maybe you are laid off and you're going to get your job back, but it's always good to have a cushion so that you can pay your rent, you can pay your utilities, and you can pay, you can pay those necessary expenses every month. And so once you have your emergency fund put aside, then you can start to think about an investment account. And there are some investment accounts that you can open online that will manage money for you. And you can start with as little as $250 or $500 as an initial investment. I'm a really big proponent of, you know, slow and easy goes the race. You think that $10 here or $10 there doesn't matter. But when you think about how money can grow, it is unbelievable. You know, money is something that we spend, but it's also something that should work for you.
Wow.
I have a question.
Sure.
So I think it's really especially important for women. How can we build what I call a mattress fund? Mm-hmm. And how can we hide that from our partners? Money that they don't know about. So like, I like to keep money for a plane ticket, money for a U-Haul, and money for storage at all times, no matter what. But I feel like I could do a better job. And how much should we strive to have in our mattress fund? And where should we stash it?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And also with Samantha, it depends on where you want to go. If you want to go to San Tropez, that plane ticket might be a little bit more than if you just want to go and see your parents. But, sort of in all seriousness, I think that I like that idea. I think that couples argue over money. And I think that if you, to the extent that it's practical, if you can keep your finances separate, now everyone can't do that, but I think it's really important to have money that you have access to that you're not going to be judged about, that it's a pool of money. And if you decide, guess what, I'm going to go out and get a manicure this week, even though things are tight, I set aside this money for my mental health because I want to just have something that I can do for myself, that's really important. In terms of putting a dollar amount, I don't know what that dollar amount is. I mean, everybody has a different financial threshold. I would think that in terms of, back to your point, think about what it would cost if, wow, I needed to get out. I needed to go and I needed to buy a plane ticket. I needed to buy a train ticket. You can actually cost out what those things look like.
I agree with you.
In terms of building the fund.
I totally agree with you, Karen. And I always believe that girls, we always should have our own money. I always say that.
It is so important.
So it's so important. So Karen, how is this a good time right now to do investment because you know what's going on in the country right now?
That's a really, really tough question. And I think, and I want to just disclose that the opinions that I'm sharing are really just my opinions and sort of how I approach the market. I am involved with finance, but I'm not a registered investment advisor. However, I've been doing this for 30 years, and I think that I've had some level of success in just following some common sense rules. The market right now is very volatile. You will see certain areas of the market that are suffering as a result of COVID, and then other areas of the market that aren't. You think about takeout. You think about all the things that we're doing right now We're ordering in. We're having groceries delivered. Mm-hmm. This is why Amazon stock has gone through the roof. But if you look at,
so that would be
you look
good
at retailers, really you look at hotels. With. I'm sorry, Louise.
That would be a good stock to go with Amazon, right?
Well, Amazon's, I use it as an example, but it's a really high price stock. It wouldn't be where I would start.
How much? Is it $5,000, $2,000?
Wow, that's a really good question. I know that Amazon is north of, I think Amazon is north of $250 a share. So that's a pretty... That's a pretty expensive stock.
Yeah.
In terms of timing the market, I don't think anybody can really time the market. I think that's one of the reasons to think about talking to an investment advisor or think about investing in funds that help you set up what your goals are and where you want to where you want to be financially in 5 or 10 or 15 years from now.
So, Karen, let me ask you this question, darling. Mm-hmm. So, do you think, shall we go to our regular bank or should we go to, where can we open this management account?
That's a very good question. So, you have companies like Merrill Lynch and you have companies like TD Ameritrade, which allow you to open accounts online. You can transfer money from your checking account or your savings account directly into a brokerage account, and then you would be responsible for picking your own investments. Personally, I have an investment advisor, and there is another online investment advisor that I've invested in called Betterment. They've been great. They are for the beginning investors. You set up a profile, you talk about what your goals are, you talk about how old you are and how much risk you're willing to take, and they come up with a portfolio mix for you. And they've been really great.
Wonderful. And you know, I think this is extremely important. And this is very quick, one thing, you know, people think that investing in the market, is like they have this idea they're going to get rich overnight. So no. Very quick, darling, tell us the pros and cons.
Pros, stocks are liquid. When you buy a stock, you can sell it. There will always be a buyer for your stock. But here's the con. They may not be a buyer at where you bought it. So you could buy a stock for $10 a share. And if you need that money next week, you can sell that stock. But there's no guarantee that you're going to be able to sell it at or above where you bought it. So that's a pro and a con.
Yes.
I think that another thing is you can keep track of your investments. Because stocks and mutual funds are very liquid assets, every day you can check and see exactly how much money you've made or lost. And that's a really important concept. It's really important for you to be able to understand that there is liquidity, but there's also some volatility. And you have to think about where you feel comfortable taking risk. The stock market has historically grown over time. There have been dips and there have been advances. But if you look at the value of a stock, or if you look at the value of the market, let's say in 1980, and you compare it to now, it is multiples higher. So if you had invested $100, you would have multiples of $100 more as a result of the growth of the stock market.
So it's a timing. It's nothing that's going to happen overnight like a lot of people think of. So ladies, we have no more time, and I know this is such an interesting topic. And
wow.
I know it's 20 minutes already, but it's extremely important that whoever is watching us, ladies, and you are interested in the stock market, the most important is do due research. Please, yes. Please, I hope that this show has, inspired you to go and do the research, and this is something that you would like to. But very quick, ladies, what, Samantha, do you have any app or any book that you can recommend to the ladies that are watching us right now?
Yeah, I saw something called Robinhood, and it looked like a great app for a first-time investor with very little capital to start with. And I know that there's something called a Spider that I could buy for $1,000 a pop in different categories of the market. What do you think?
I love that. I'm going to check this out. And Delena?
Well, we didn't get to talk about IRAs, which is what I have since I don't have a staff job where I'm going to an employer. So I think we're just going to have to save it until next time. I use AXA Advisor. So, I say if you have your money in one place, you can put it in an IRA and watch it build there. We'll have to talk more about that next time.
We'll have to talk more about that. And Karen, what do you recommend?
I recommend, I'm going to go with Delaina, and I'm going to say IRAs. And number one thing, if you have a company with a 401k, you must invest in it.
Yes.
Number one thing, you'll be amazed at what that can do for you.
Wonderful. And ladies, I love learning, and I love learning like a 101. And I read about this book, the Dummies Collection. They have an amazing book about how to learn more about the stock market and the technical analysis for dummies. So
yes, that's one of my classmates. His name is Eric Tyson. So,
yes, I love the books, the whole collection of this series of books. So before we go, ladies, we have a quarantine's birthday. Lena, who are we wishing birthday today?
Okay, we have to wish a happy birthday to Ginger Murray.
Ginger, now, happy birthday!
Let me tell you that she is just a year before baby boomer started. So if you go do your homework, you can find out how old she turned yesterday.
Wow.
Age is just a number.
My oldest friend in the whole wide world, Odetta McLeish White, friends for 45 years. Happy, 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 my love.
Yay. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, darling. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, Ansa. Thank you, everybody, for joining us and watching Sexy Stylist. Remember, if you are interested in the stock market, the most important is do your own research. Research, research. And remember, knowledge is power and knowledge is very sexy. Be kind to yourself and others. Besitos.
Besitos.